Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining this fireside chat session. Today, our topic of discussion is around how CSPs or telco companies can shape the future of industrial IoT. Today, we have a fantastic panel of experts with us that are going to share their thoughts and expertise. So I'm going to ask Ajay to introduce himself, and then we'll move. Go ahead,
sure.
Ajay. Thanks.
So first of all, thank you, Hadi, for inviting me. My pleasure to be here. My name is Ajay Rane. I lead global business development for the Telco BU, focused on working with our global CSP customers, helping them move up the value chain. So whether it's in the smart home or it's industrial IoT or even looking at marketplaces as a mechanism to monetize the future. So happy to be here.
Thanks for joining. Suzanne?
Suzanne Zmenak. I'm the global account manager for Telus. So I lead the overall team for AWS.
Thanks for being here.
Hi, Hadi. Hanif Datoo. I'm the VP of Business Development over at in our Industry Solutions Group at Telus, and I'm very pleased to be here. Thank you.
So let's start with you, Suzanne, about this new announcements. We hear all these great news about the strategy partnership between Telus and AWS, but even we go deeper into that topic and also get to our topic of industrial IoT, I think our audience would like to know more about the history of relationship between Telus and AWS. So if you can provide us that overview.
Sure, absolutely. So I've been working with the Telus team for almost 2.5 years now. And when I joined the team, we were really focused more on smaller workloads. A lot of them resided within the health space. And we were not getting the traction of a more strategic relationship. So it was quite a journey over the last 2 years to get us to a more strategic partnership.
That was a great point you mentioned, Suzanne. So then, what would be the next opportunities that you see are available there through this strategic partnership with Telus?
Well, Telus is unique in the industry that they have Telus Health as well as Telus Agriculture, both very large businesses for Telus. And I believe that smart home application has so many opportunities within those two areas, as well as extending it to the enterprise so that Telus can enable their customers.
Great, great. And the thing that we see these days with telcos or communication service providers, Hanif, is it's about that they're going beyond only providing connectivity services to the customers, because for having a reliable IoT service, you need reliable connectivity. And that's where the core competency and unique value proposition that telcos can offer. But what other services, value-add services, Telus is offering? What is your strategy and vision around that? And how do you think cloud can enable you to achieve that vision and strategy?
Sure. Thank you. So I'd start with getting beyond connectivity is a core proposition of what we're doing in Telus Business Solutions. We've set up a separate group called Industry Solutions to specifically tackle the issues that our business partners have. So our thesis is we want to look at things like private networks. We're looking at things like, in our automotive sector, traffic as a core competency that we would add in addition to our connectivity for vehicles. We're looking at applications like Connected Worker to help lone workers in challenging environments and bringing that to bear on our private networks. And we're also looking at intelligent spaces and how we would deal with smart buildings, our base stations. Saving money is never a bad thing for a telco. And considering how we bring that all together, it has to be foundational on the cloud. And that's why, you know, whether it's mobile edge compute, whether it's the cloud compute, all of these aspects need an underlay of cloud. And if they're going to talk to each other where we think the real data benefits will happen, that's where we need deep understanding of cloud propositions as well as data.
Oh, amazing. And in that case, you mentioned cloud application or capabilities that cloud provide you to provide that vision. And now, Ajay, what do you think the current initiatives and existing collaborations that AWS have around IoT, and I specifically mentioned multiple industries and now industrial IoT here?
Absolutely. So, you know, industrial IoT is just one of the areas where Hanif mentioned. And you know, at AWS, we are providing the undifferentiated heavy lifting so that our partners can create solutions that can be scaled very quickly and go to market very quickly. So when our CSP customers like Telus want to launch new products and services, we have a large ecosystem of partners who we work with to develop solutions for industrial IoT, for healthcare, for automotive, and be able to offer that at scale and have a vast ecosystem of partners who will now take advantage of some of the AWS IoT services that we have, for whether it's for industrial IoT, such as TwinMaker, for example, for on a factory floor or another industrial setting. So those are some examples of what we do. And then everything is also related to making sure that this connectivity is secure. So building on a secure cloud platform and be able to scale it globally and be available.
So great. So it seems based on what you just said, this relationship that exists now between AWS and Telus is going beyond being a customer, Telus being a customer, and AWS being a technology provider. Now it's gone to the next level of collaboration and innovation. So Suzanne, what's your point of view on this transformation of relationship?
Well, like many telcos, Telus has a stated intent to be multi-cloud. And they have strong partnerships and relationships with other cloud providers. So my strategy was to look at areas that we could help Telus grow revenue outside of their core competencies, leveraging the strong relationships that they have with the consumer. And so our most recent announcement is around collaboration in smart home, where we are bringing a whole new level of ubiquitous control to the smart home in one application. So it's very exciting. And once we launch in Canada, we will jointly go to market globally to other CSPs and bring this same solution, platform as a service, to these CSPs.
Amazing. And Hanif, what's your point of view in this new relationship?
So I got to see the connected home here that got created in consumer. I immediately started thinking of ideas of how I could take that to automotive and create automotive experiences around that connected home. Wouldn't it be nice if I could turn on my heating as I'm driving home, turn it up because I'm frugal.
Right.
So this made me very jealous, and I was very excited about what we could do here. And I think you basically start a trend. And now we can take that to our OEM partners and bring that into their vehicles and create that experience that engages them in a meaningful way in something that has been heretofore like impossible to do.
Great, because now you mentioned connected home. Now we're talking about connected car and how we can connect these two together. So in that case, then how do you think this could help you to provide better impact to your customer? And specifically around automotive industry, what trends do you see? And again, that collaboration that both companies can have together to innovate and create something new to provide that superior user experience.
I think there are so many problems that automotive companies are going through right now as they think about moving towards connected and autonomous vehicles, that they have to stage the problems that they're going to tackle. But that user experience is foundational to the whole thing. So getting that right from the beginning is critical. But also as the vehicles move towards software defined, that creates opportunities for many parties in the ecosystem to really collaborate. And I think creating that amazing user experience, we've seen what that can do in the vehicle industry, and we're pretty excited about how we could shape that as we go forward, both whether that be through traffic, whether that be through the infotainment systems, and of course, making sure that we keep emissions down, keep people safe.
Right. Basically, we're talking about smarter cars, safer cars, as well as more efficient cars, right? In that case, Ajay, so what do you think are opportunities and collaborations between Telus and AWS to innovate a new features, capabilities, and offer it to the customers?
Yep, so as Hanif said, there are many opportunities and many challenges that automakers face today, and we are addressing them not just Telus as a customer of ours, but also as a partner. The commitment that Telus has made to being a part of the ecosystem as an ISV in some cases, for example, in the smart home. And similarly, you know, the discussions that we're having around the automotive space, whether it is looking at traffic as a solution, but also looking at automotive manufacturing. And that's a very large industrial use case. So bringing all those technologies together, taking advantage of the services that we have in the telco space for CSPs, for automotive, I think that's going to make a huge impact and could be transformational. So just to give you a few examples, you know, you look at network functions. So Telus as an operator has several different network functions that could be used by automakers, whether it's for hyper-precise location services and offering them to automakers around the world, or in the manufacturing space, creating digital twins of an automotive manufacturing facility, offering connectivity, you know, whether it's private networks and maybe have multiple levels of private network, you know, not just cellular, but could be Wi-Fi and others. And offering that integrated experience and bringing that to market for automakers, as manufacturers, but also as auto OEMs and offering that to consumers. So I think Telus has covered the breadth of that industry by participating in the different parts of that ecosystem, both as an operator as well as a partner and a provider of solutions for that technology. So that's why we are super excited about our collaboration with Telus and we're grateful for the partnership.
Great, because as Ajay mentioned, now we're seeing transformation in two areas of impact of IoT in automotive industry. One on the manufacturing side, so better the transformation of manufacturing and designing of the cars, and also transformation of user experience, as you mentioned, by having the user being able to drive and use voice assistance to make changes through the connection to the home and take the garage door open, make the garage door open, or turn on all lights off, on and off. So in that case, what do you think the next steps that you have in your roadmap, and what do you think and foresee in terms of the impact in your growth and your strategy?
Sure. I mean, first, there's so much we're trying to do, but I'm just going to focus on one aspect that Ajay mentioned, which is, you know, the next thing that I'd really like to look at is that hyper-precise location. Vehicles are going to need this as they kind of move through. So in Canada, we will be building out a hyper-precise location network across the footprint to enable a lot of the automotive use cases, in addition to the customer experiences, connectivity. But I think location is addictive, whether that be in the factory or whether that be outside of the factory. And combining the indoor and outdoor positioning becomes a challenge that we're going to have to get through over the next period as well.
Amazing. So great opportunities there for both companies to collaborate and innovate. So great conversation. Thanks you for joining, and I'll hope to see you next time.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.